Good morning. Today is June 10th, 2021, and today we're filming up here on top of a levee, and behind us is a young Chandler orchard, and then off to the left is our family garden that is kind of a traditional garden that we've always had here at Carriere Family Farms.
We'll start this conversation off discussing the shipping report, which will be available via link. But numbers looked great, really strong this month again, which is fantastic. And domestically, we saw those numbers strengthen up, which was nice. They looked to be a little weak initially coming into season, but now they're starting to pick up speed heading into new crop. And export numbers?
About the same. We're seeing most of the markets be up, and we're just kind of finishing up the last few shipments we have for the season. We're still seeing some interest come in from the export market, but for the most part, everyone's pretty well sold on LHP and Chandler LHP. We're also starting to hear that chili might also be pretty well committed, and we are really starting to expect a pretty aggressive opening into new crop, as most of the other countries that grow walnuts are also seeing short supply. China has also reported early on that they've seen quite a bit of frost coming in and damaging a little bit of their crop as well. So we expect, as far as the Chile and China crop, to really be quite empty as we come into harvest here shortly.
Yeah, that being said, we're going to come into this harvest on fumes, so hopefully you all have your contracts that are carrying you through. I know that as far as export shipping goes, it's not the greatest news, but it's not the worst news. We still have strong shipments coming into the U.S. from China, so that's affecting our ability to get shipments out. And Hamburg Süd has also announced that it's going to go every other week into Northern Europe. We've seen other shipping lines decide they're going to follow suit. So I'm not sure how that's going to affect Europe's ability to bring in product coming fourth quarter. And we've had a couple of shipping lines add stops at the Oakland port. So that's kind of been not necessarily helping port congestion. So the good news is that we have seen more stable bookings and less rejections. So that's on the bright side. We're able to get those in place for our customers and hopefully get product out a little bit better. But according to all sources, this really isn't going to improve through quarters 3 and 4.
And then as far as new crop goes, it's developing pretty well. We've seen little to no water. We did get a little tiny bit of a thunderstorm last night, but overall, we really have not seen anywhere close to the amount of water that we normally receive here in California. So that's becoming a major issue. And we're lucky that walnuts are primarily planted in Northern California, a little bit more heavily than the southern part of the state. So walnuts should have a little bit easier time with the drought this year than maybe almonds. But at the same time, it's still a major concern for walnuts. Today, we're sitting on top of a levee, which traditionally will hold back some floodwaters from the river, but we haven't seen that happen for a couple years now, which just really indicates how low and how limited the water supply is here in California. And then we're gonna move over and visit Jared a little bit from the farm side. He's gonna show us a little bit more about how the crop is developing and what they're seeing in the orchard.
Welcome back out to our home ranch here in Glen. Right now we're standing next to one of our Chandler blocks. The crop is looking better than we originally anticipated. Now that's not to say the entire crop is looking that way. It's still looking pretty spotty throughout the different regions we have in the valley. This block has definitely looked better as the nut size has continued to expand. Last week we did deal with a little bit of a heat wave. Typically, our Chandlers are not affected by high temperatures as much as some of our other varieties, such as Tulare. We typically judge the susceptibility off of what the internal meats look like. So right now, you can cut into a Chandler, and you can see that we're still in the kind of the jelly, watery stage of what the kernel is. Typically, when we see that in nuts, we know they're not that quite susceptible to sunburn damage. This week we're dealing with a lot cooler temperatures, which the trees are loving right now, and it's letting us catch up on our irrigations. But next week it does look like we're going to be dealing with some hotter temperatures once again, and so that will be the time you'll see a lot of growers out in the orchards putting on the kaolinite products, which act as some type of a sunscreen for the trees and keep them a little bit more protected than what they would be just being naturally out there.
So we'd like to thank you for sharing a little bit of our news with us. And if you have any questions, please feel free to reach out, whether it's phone, WhatsApp, email, whatever's easiest for you. We're happy to answer the questions that we can.
As always, thank you guys for watching. Best wishes to you, your family, and your teams.